No federal funding for streetcars. Why a decision made in Washington might affect Kansas City's public transit future. A new high-rise apartment building in downtown. Johnson County gets ready for massive cuts to the Joe and the grand reopening of Kansas City's Black Archives. Hello and welcome to the program that goes beyond the soundbite and sometimes beyond the newspaper quote to bring you insight and analysis of the important news in and around the Kansas City area. You may have noticed that I'm Dave Helling. Now I'm sitting in for Nick Haynes, who is taking some well-deserved time off. Don't worry, Nick will be back sitting in the chair next week, but I can only hope to match his eloquence in the next 30 minutes. That's the goal anyway. The rest of the band is intact, though. Joining us to discuss the major issues of the week, my friend and colleague Lynn Horsley of the Kansas City Star. Lynn, thanks for coming. The Kansas City Call's Eric Wesson, Chris Hernandez of NBC Action News, 41 Action News, and Dana Wright, co-host of Radioactive on KMBZ Radio each afternoon. Hi, Dana.
Hi.
Okay, let's talk about streetcars first. Petula Clark said it best. You can forget all your troubles, forget all your cares, and go downtown. And in this case, two important downtown stories surfaced this week. Kansas City lost out on a $25 million federal grant to help build a proposed streetcar line, even as ballots are sent out to begin the process of voting and the part of the local share of that $100 million project. At the same time, the Cordish Company announced plans to construct a high-rise apartment complex at 13th and Walnut if the city council ponies up some tax breaks and cash. We'll talk about that in a minute. But first, let's talk about the streetcar issue, which now seems to be at a real crossroads. The failure to win the grant certainly does no favors for Mayor Sly James and other supporters of the plan. But the denial of those funds isn't the end of the city's streetcar discussion. In fact, as Chris Hernandez reported this week, the debate on a downtown streetcar line seems primed to go on.
Sue Burke is thrilled Kansas City lost out on the federal grant. She hopes that kills the streetcar project before it kills her business.
I have to be able to run my business from here, having access to my front door.
Burke owns Kansas City Air Filter and the building it's in on Grand Street in the River Market. She says the streetcar will take away customer parking, block trucks coming to her business, and increase her property taxes.
It's just not right to be charging people more for the privilege of buying things downtown who aren't ever going to ride the stupid streetcar.
Partially kind of disappointed, obviously.
David Johnson lives and works downtown and has been pushing to build support for the streetcar. Ballots were mailed today for the first of two elections that could create a local funding stream with higher sales and property taxes.
The people that I've just spoken to since you broke the news, none of them are changing their votes. Now I tend to talk to people who are super supportive.
The streetcar would run the 2 miles between River Market and Union Station.
We'll go and look for other sources, other grants, other things that were more cumbersome perhaps, might take a little more time. This was going to be the way for us to move in the most efficient, quickest way. It wasn't the only way to do it.
The $25 million federal grant would have paid about one quarter of the overall cost.
Again, that was Chris Hernandez reporting. Chris, you get the sense that the city wasn't overwhelmingly surprised that they lost out on this grant, but it did come at a pretty bad time in terms of the ballots and the people downtown making
that decision. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, they were not overwhelmingly surprised, but keep in mind at the same time, this was clearly meant to be the launch pad for construction of this project. It was, if they had won the grant, it would have been money in the bank. You get going, there's a quarter of your cost right there.
Plus picked up some enthusiasm, you would think, among the public about this project, which seems less focused on streetcars than maybe other people would like.
Well, and part of it is like, hey, if we get this grant, then this election to instill this tax, these higher taxes in the local downtown area, that was supposed to go hand in hand, that you'd win that election
right,
because you now have this. And see, we're not shouldering the burden all ourselves here in Kansas City. We got this federal money. That obviously is not part of the equation.
So Lynn, why did we lose this grant? Why didn't we get the $25 million from the feds?
Well, for a couple of reasons. There were 700 communities that applied for this money, $10 billion in requests. They had less than $500 million to allocate. So it was always going to be very competitive. And Kansas City streetcar plan isn't quite together yet. The feds like for you to have your local match in hand when they give you their federal dollars. And it's always been a chicken and the egg thing with Kansas City. We need the federal grant to build enthusiasm for the local match, but
right,
we need the local match to get the federal money.
Yeah, but Eric, we've been talking about this, mass transit on fixed rail for as long as I've been in Kansas City. And when Lynn says, well, we weren't quite ready, that some people will find that shocking that we, at this point in time, we still don't know exactly what we want to do.
Well, to be fair, this is a new plan. I mean, this is a 2-mile streetcar route. We've been taught for years, we've talked about 25 miles of light rail, or and this is very different. It's supposed to be more compact, cheaper to do, easier, faster.
But I guess the broader concern is that Kansas City, for whatever reason, really can't figure out what to do with fixed rail. Am I right or wrong about that?
And you got the county, they have an idea that they want to implement. Now you've got the city, and it's going back and forth. Who's got the actual plan that can be used? And now we're finding out that really nobody has a plan. They just got an idea.
You can't change the fact, and it doesn't matter which plan we go with here, that we live in one of the most spread out metropolitan communities in America. You can't change that. So if you live in Olathe or Independence or Leawood or Overland Park, I'm not going to drive my car 25 minutes to the River Market to park it and get on some mass transit system to go see Union Station. I'll just get in my car and drive from the River Market to Union Station. There's no tolerance in this economy, Dave, to pay anything for this unless you live and work downtown. I'm not saying it wouldn't be great if you're already down there. What good is anyone else?
But Chris, isn't the idea to sort of use this as a teaser method to get people enthused about light rail, a broader light rail over the next 20, 25 years?
Partially, but the real impetus for this among the city council and the mayor and civic leaders downtown is the economic development that will come from having a fixed system. I mean, that's the difference between having a bus line and doing something like light rail or streetcars, is that you have specific stops that are going to be there permanently, and that's what is what will attract economic development.
But you have people in your piece who are not very enthused about that idea at all, and they're on the line. I mean, it isn't a deal where hey, build it and they will come. They don't want it at all.
Supporter of streetcar who saw that interview and then talked to me about it said, that lady has it all wrong. They say she should be excited. If she doesn't want to be there because trucks need to get in and out of her business, that she should sell her building at a profit and then just move to some warehouse area where the trucks can get in and out. Yeah. So that's part of the battle that's going on out there in the streets right now, is how is this going to work and who's going
to
benefit?
We want to move on to the next topic, but Lynn, just to wrap this up, do you get a sense that the council is enthusiastic about going back to the feds next year and years after that? Or do they want to wait and see what the public does, the downtown public does on this proposal?
They'll know pretty quickly. July 31st is when these ballots are due back, whether we're going to create this local district. I think they do intend to try to go back to the feds, though, because they don't want to have to bear the entire $100 million cost all on local taxpayers.
All right.